guys, Tim here. Today we're going to take a look at this AverMedia. It's the Live Gamer HD. This is to capture and share full HD 1080p video. And sorry, the box is extremely shiny and I'm having a heck of a time not getting me or the lights there. You can live stream with XSplit and it is Windows 8 compatible. Not much information on the back. So we'll go. I will say, nice packaging. Looks really good. I mean, just a box, but I guess when you have something this small that's, you know, $140 or $150, then you can put a little bling in there, I guess. So it is extremely well protected. This is actually one of the better packages I've seen in quite a while for a card. So in the bottom of the box, in the bottom of the shiny red box, you have the AverMedia disc, an XSplit broadcaster gift card, and a whole mess of cables and things. It's my highly whole mess of cables technical term there. So, eighth inch to eighth inch. We have an HDMI to PCI. There we go. Same thing. One's female to male, and the other one is HDMI male to female. Also comes with an HDMI cable, and the user guide. In the box, we have the card and under the box, we have the recording button. So talk a little bit about this first. Just interfaces with the media. It's a USB 2.0, and it's basically just a, you know, quick and easy stop-start button for recording gameplay. So if you're, you know, say you have a single monitor, you're streaming through, you don't want to leave the game to start recording, you just hit that and it'll start your recording. That way you can, you know, take custom videos and not have to edit them quite so much, right? You don't have to record half an hour of gameplay for that 30 seconds you wanted to record, you know, somewhere down the road. Very nice black PCB. It's actually quite gorgeous. So, then it actually does have, I believe it's for shielding, not for anything else. It's not a heat sink or anything, so it's either to protect the chips or it's shielding. Or it's advertising, I guess, as well. So, and it's just a 1X PCIe. You have an HDMI in and an HDMI out, an audio in and an audio out. So one thing you can do with this is you can actually, if you have a splitter, you can actually put your mic back through it. So you can combine audio and your voice audio at the same time. It is a little tricky, but not bad. So the supported resolutions are 640 by 480, 720 by 480, 720 by 576, 800 by 600, 1024 by 768, a whole bunch of 1280s by random numbers, and then the one that really matters to most people is the 1920 by 1080. This card is meant, some people may put this in a separate capture box, but this card is meant to do capture or streaming from the machine it's being played in. The CPU overhead is very low. I'm just looking to see on the box here if there's anything I may have missed. Oh yeah, it's H.264 hardware compression, native from the card. Oh, and I just realized, yeah, so earlier, I think I said PCI, yeah, DVI. Brain no worky, apparently. So this is HDMI female to DVI male, DVI female to HDMI male. So basically, if you have a DVI monitor and DVI cables, then you're okay because you now have the needed splitters to switch things back around. So that's all for this video. It's kind of a self-explanatory item. We're going to use it to do some game streaming. Might open a Twitch TV account that, you know, probably nobody will watch, but hey, something to do. I'm also going to be using this for game reviews, so you'll be seeing some of those coming soon. Plan on focusing on more, I will do some AAA titles if they're ones that I want to play, but I'm more interested in like Greenlight or indie games, or stuff on like good old games, stuff that a lot of people these days may not know about, or you know, like, oh, those are horrible graphics, why would I ever play this game? I mean, you're missing out. There's games out there like the original Baldur's Gate, the original Betrayal at Krondor, Space Quest, Police Quest, King's Quest, like a lot of the old Sierra games, which is, for you guys that know, is now Valve, you know, how they got started. So, it's very interesting stuff. They're kind of short games, mind you, but all the same. We will be bringing those out. Leave in the comments whether you guys think that I should just put them in this channel, with like a series name. So maybe like, you know, Timmy Game Reviews, colon, and the name of the game. Or if you think, you know, should I start another channel or do people even care? So, you know, leave that in the comments. Please give a thumb up, guys. Please subscribe. Really appreciate all the feedback I've been getting. Look forward to doing more of these videos. And this is Tim for Timmy Tech TV. We'll see you next time.